All right, everybody, welcome back to Nick Nacks Presents Mass Effect 3. We are in the... just got through the party here on the Citadel, so we are dealing with the aftermath
Omega,
of the party.
Sky was color of fit cam tuned to a dead Vorcha. Business so bad that if Volus would have sold my suit... Then trouble Doppler shifted deep Asari blue as it came through my door. Likely Elcor father. High gravity adapted in all right places. Asari said Krogan thug after her business. If could get rid of him, said she'd be grateful for all eternity. Found Krogan in slums. First shot hit primary heart, but Krogan have redundant nervous system. Felt redundant, nervous myself. Krogan got me in stranglehold. Used incineration attack. Got lucky. Said this was an easy job, he gasped. Guess we'd both been burned. Asari very grateful. Could read her like open book. And as it happened, did enjoy reading. In bed. Woke up looking at barrel of pearl-handled Carnifex. My M98 in another room. Another Black Widow standing over me. Only loose end left, she said. Her mistake. Didn't know I'd been in STG. Learned tricks dirty enough to clog a Quarian soup filter. Your barrier's very similar to your morals, I said, and threw my biotic grenade. Warped. When woke up from explosion, Asari had fled back to afterlife. Felt lucky not to be in afterlife myself. Hadn't been paid, but considered self-fortunate. Had broken Omega's one rule, in more ways than one.
Nice.
Morning, Chef. You went all out with the breakfast supplies. I didn't know you could get real milk on the Citadel. I had some. Thought it was soy. I'm not really lactose intolerant. I just don't put up with lactose's stupid drama. In case I don't see you again, thanks. That was a lot of fun. I should go. Stupid dairy products. Hey.
Did we, break anything last night? I don't suppose you need anything around here. Calibrated. Yeah, okay, maybe I should just stop saying that word, but only if Liara stops saying,
by the goddess.
Good thing this place has extra bathrooms. Miranda takes forever to do her hair. You'd think with her genes, she wouldn't need to.
Was someone making tea? I could use some tea. The apartment seems so quiet now. The apartment seems so quiet now.
Shepard, good morning. I want to thank you for inviting me here. It was good to see everyone again. I hope you enjoyed your evening as well.
Going to die. I didn't know you could go through that many toxin filters in one night. Do I have a tattoo? I remember something about a tattoo. Don't get me wrong. Great party, but... yeah. just be here. Right here. Forever.
Glad to see you had a good time, Tally.
Shepard, I was just going to lift some weights. Want to join? I feel fantastic. How about everyone else? 1085, 1086, 1087. Shepard?
Hey, you look like shit. You know the best part of an overcharged biotic amp? No hangovers. Even normal biotics get hangovers. But I can drink until I puke and still wake up just peachy. That was fun. You guys even kept up with me there for a while. Hey. Hey.
Love you.
Some neighbors came by last night to complain about the noise. I put their bodies in the building incinerator. That was a joke. I have nothing else to report. I recommend breakfast.
Thanks, Edie.
Morning, Shepard. Hope you slept well. Oh, I would have thought all those tequila shots with James would have prepared me for last night. What a night. Wish it never ended. Thanks, Shepard. Thanks, Shepard.
Shepard, good to see you up. Hope I didn't wake anyone up with my snoring. I go like a buzzsaw since I got my nose broke. By the way, you're almost out of bacon. Our bacon, anyway. There's still some of that dextro shit in the freezer. I saved you 3 strips. Figured it was fair payback for all the times you saved mine, right?
That's fair.
Shepard?
Hey, Commander. Hell of a night. So I've managed not to throw up. Feeling pretty good about that. Oh, if everyone could just not talk so loudly, that would be great. Or close the cupboards too loud. Or walk too loud. You know, just think quiet thoughts. Ugh. Still fun, though. Commander. Commander.
Been a while since I hit the hard stuff. About time. You live past 700. You start paying for a night like that the next morning.
So last night, I didn't... I'm checking extranet sites. No hits yet, so maybe I just imagined that last part. I'm almost sure someone was recording us, though. Oh, I should probably talk to Edie. Or, alternatively, I should never talk to Edie ever again. It's not my fault. I was overserved. Hey. Hey.
Might be difficult for you to never talk to Edie again, Trainer.
I think I broke my head on something last night. Bathroom is all cleaned up, Shepard. Good as new. Shepard. Shepard.
Morning, Shepard. Had a lovely time last night. I see everyone survived the festivities, more or less. Mmm. Good tea. Mmm.
Okay, who wants eggs? Liara, eggs? Trainer. Esteban, eggs? Joker, where is that guy? Ash, come on, I promised you eggs. Rex, buddy, eggs? Tally? Ah, she'll definitely want eggs. Javik, man, you gotta try my eggs. Anyone else? Miranda? Shepard? Eggs? Shepard? Shepard?
Shepard? Morning. I need a floor to curl up on. Oh, not so loud. Hey. Hey.
Alrighty then. Check. I kind of forgot I had a couple more things to do out here that I didn't get to.
The worst part? After that mission, the ex-servers guy was bragging about how many kills he had.
Not about competition. About saving Galaxy as team.
You are totally right. Totally right. So, if you want, N7 operative intel, so if you ever wanted to deploy together.
What rifle do you use?
Oh, it's a Widow. A Widow 3, in fact.
When get to Widow 10, you call me.
Officer, someone requested my presence concerning an incident with the Krogan.
Right this way, Commander.
So, Grunt, anything you want to tell me about?
This clown wants to take me to lockup. Figured I'd give you a call, straighten this out.
Commander Shepard, I apologize for the intrusion. This Krogan insisted we contact you.
It's okay. I'll vouch for him. I'll sign any paperwork you have, officer.
Yes, sir.
What happened?
I don't know. Drank a bit, left the hospital, broke a few windows.
But you were in that hospital recovering from the Rachni encounter.
Yeah, didn't feel like sticking around.
Most people stick around long enough to, you know, heal.
Most people aren't me.
And why is CSEC here?
Guess they're precious about some broken glass.
Before I sign you up, everybody walked away from this in one piece, right?
Sure, yeah, everybody's fine. Hospital seen better days, though.
Right. Tell me about the windows.
A couple of squad mates broke me out for my birthday. Tried lowering me down the side of the building on a rope. It didn't work out.
It's your birthday?
No, I'm tank bred, remember? Anyway, we got some pictures on the Krogan Memorial.
In the Presidium?
Yeah. When CSEC got there, they were mad. Or maybe they were mad about their car being on fire. Can't remember.
Why was it on fire?
I threw my bottle of Ringcall at it. Pretty strong stuff. Went up like a bonfire. The CSEC guys jumped out. Then I figured they didn't want it, so I took it. We didn't get very far before they shut us down. Sorry to say, riot foam. Didn't work so well on me.
And why is that?
Because I was on fire, you know, from the car. Come on, Shepard, keep up.
Right. Sorry. So how did they catch you?
Got hungry. Bought some noodles.
Grunt, you apologized to the nice man for setting his car on fire.
Fine. I'm sorry for setting your car on fire. And I won't do it again.
Good. Now, officer, I can pay for any damages that may have occurred.
That's what you've been signing for, Commander. You're lucky, Krogan. Don't let me catch you up here again.
You won't. Thank you, officer. So, how were those noodles?
A little spicy.
You're my hero, Grunt.
Okay, so Jacob is here.
Oh, he came round once I explained the hijack's importance to the production. They'll work marvelously together. Once the hijack stops scaling the set pieces and making nests out of the props.
Oh, my.
Not to worry, productions always appear disastrous until just before the curtain rises.
Oh, of course. It's going to be an amazing show.
I won't lie.
Hey, Shepard, over here. Thanks for coming by. Good to see you. What's up?
Out for a little R&R. You?
Exactly. Same thing.
Hey, Jacob. I'm out of credits.
Who are they?
Their parents are MIA. Volunteered to take them on for the weekend, get their minds off things. What about us, Shepard? It's got to be a game of skill in there with our names on it.
Let's do it.
Great.
This is your game of skill.
Now, Shepard, I'll try not to embarrass you.
Really? Trash talk? That shattered Izo?
Hell yeah, my pride is on the line. Also, these kids look up to me, so I have to take you down.
You're gonna take me down? I don't think so.
Well, step up, Shepard. Although it might be tough not having your squad to carry you.
You're on.
No pressure, Shepard. These people already idolize you. So when you choke, it won't matter.
You're crowding me.
Am I? My bad. Stand back, everyone. Shepard needs extra room to make the magic happen.
Ready? Let's do this.
Glad none of your friends are here to see your humiliation. Yes!
That all you got?
Feel that? That's the feeling of doom.
Never mind. I got this.
right?
Okay.
Yeah! Commander Shepard wins!
And that's how it's done, kids.
You couldn't just let me win, just once? Come on, Shepard. Let's grab some food. I'm buying.
Alright, that's everything.
Duty calls, huh? Even with a hangover?
There's still a war on.
Unless the Reapers are on shore leave, too?
I'm guessing they're not. Round everyone up, pass out the aspirin, and have them report to the Normandy.
You got it.
Break time's over, huh?
At least we threw one hell of a party. Probably the last one.
Knock that shit off. You're gonna blow the Reapers to hell. And then you're coming back and taking me out dancing. You know, for all the shit we've been through, we've had a damn good ride.
Alright, so the Citadel DLC all finished.
Commander, you've got a new message at your private terminal.
It's like old times. From Jack. Hey, had fun kicking some holographic ass with you. Good to see you haven't lost it without me around to keep you in line. I've got a bit more leave, so let me know if you're around and want to kill some time. How are you? From Samara. Shepard, I overheard yet another news report about you today, and I thought I'd wait to see how you're doing. Currently on the Citadel, so if there's any way that I can be of assistance to you, please do not hesitate to call. It's Mom. Please call. From Hannah Shepard. Sweetheart, it's been a long time since we spoke. Too long. Admiral Hackett recruited me to work on the Crucible. Maybe you knew that, I don't know, but that's where you'll find me. Could you call me, please, when you get a chance? I would love to talk to you, Mom. Pencil me in. From Miranda Lawson. Shepard, care for a night out? Let's get dressed up and meet in the casino. I'll be the one in red. Alright, I didn't realize there was still some more of that stuff to do.
Commander?
How's the ship holding up, Edie?
The envelope of mass-free space we create when we travel at FTL.
I had assumed you would call your mom from here since this is the comm room. Maybe up in the private quarters, probably. Updated. Although the Normandy is tough enough to withstand ship-to-ship firepower, wear and tear takes its toll. The vacuum of space, solar irradiation, the retained heat of stealth mode, and the stress of burning an onboard fusion plant all put stress on the ship's many complex systems. Alliance technicians have repaired, retrofitted, and tested the Normandy while it was in dry dock. They assure the crew that it will now perform better than ever. Updated. Crew of the Normandy, both past and present, have bonded over their shore leave experiences and vented stress that could otherwise damage their mental focus. They will fight for Shepard and for one another with renewed zeal. Head up. See if we can call our mom from our cabin. No, maybe I need to do that back at the apartment. I don't know that I'll actually have any new conversations to have with them, but can check.
Hey there. Hello, Shepard.
How's it going?
Okay, yeah, it doesn't look like we've got anything new. Just check the here first. Oh, maybe Aloes. You would think that Sanctuary would be the kind of thing that she would report on.
Okay, toughest mission.
Horizon.
No fair, I hadn't joined up with you yet.
Fine, the Dead Reaper then.
Really? The husks just ran up to us.
Have you ever noticed that I carry a sniper rifle and you're the one who likes things at short range?
And you prefer to keep everything at a distance.
Exactly. Wait, what?
Creepiest thing we fought.
The Thorian. But wait, what did you mean?
I didn't mean anything. I'm going with the Rachni.
The Queen? But we didn't fight her either time.
No, the little ones. They look like spiders and they scuttle right toward you.
I thought you liked it when things got up close and personal.
I guess it depends on who it is.
Oh, man. Bow chicka bow wow.
Nothing to report, Commander.
Hey.
Commander.
Everything okay, Shepard?
Ready when you are. Ready when you are.
Okay. I don't know why I did the mass relay. Go back to the Citadel. Let's go back to the Strip. I wanna head back to my apartment and see if I can call my mom that way. Otherwise, I don't know how I'm supposed to do that. I'm supposed to meet up with Miranda at the casino, and Jack's message said something about meeting up with her for more, missions there at Max Arsenal Arena. Call mom. There we go.
Hannah Shepard here.
Hi, Mom.
Oh, honey. Oh, it's so good to hear your voice.
This is a surprise. It's been a long time.
It has. I I just felt I needed to... I think about you every day. I try not to worry. The other day, I was remembering the bedtime stories we used to make up. You had your own ship and crew. The stories were always filled with adventure and danger.
Oh, yeah. Haven't thought about that in a while.
Me neither. Oh, you'd always swoop in to punish the bad guys to save the day. So, there you are. Even when you were little, you dreamed of the life you have.
Is that the reason you wanted me to call?
No. I just want you to know that I am proud of you, son. So proud.
Thanks, Mom.
I have to go.
I know.
Be safe. Please. Goodbye, sweetheart.
Alright, and we'll do some, we can finish up with Jack.
I came as quickly as I could. What's wrong?
I didn't mean to worry you. We just didn't get much of a chance to talk at the party.
We've said our farewells, Shepard.
Are we gonna stand on formalities? These big picture windows remind me of our talks in the Normandy's observation lounge.
This view doesn't have quite the same effect as a galaxy of stars, but I can see where it might make one sentimental. I also enjoyed our talks, Shepard. Very much.
Hey, look what I found. An old issue of Justicar Heroes, May 2140. It says that you personally lifted 50 refugees across a raging floodplain on Nevos after smugglers blew up a dam.
That news source has been known to exaggerate.
So you didn't almost drown while saving a child who had been torn from her mother's grasp?
The smugglers were not so lucky that I survived.
Are there more stories like this?
Perhaps. You might be amused by the June 2085 issue, Justicar Samara, Cold-Blooded Justice Runs Hot. It is not so difficult for me to find stories of your exploits. I think that you are remarkable, Shepard. When the Vids sing your praises and call you a hero, does it make you blush? Do you agree? What do you feel?
It's humbling. But honestly, if people feel that I'm making a difference, that bolsters me, my team, and our efforts. What now?
I am content as we are, Shepard. Let us sit a while longer, even if there is nothing to say.
All right. Now, Jack.
So what? A private cabin on a stealth warship isn't enough for you?
I'm watching the place for a friend. What are you doing?
It's a surprise.
I like surprises.
Good. Get undressed.
This isn't what I was expecting.
That's why they call it a surprise, dumbass. Quit squirming.
You do this a lot?
Early on, yeah. Trying to cover up the Cerberus crap. Hard to keep your hands steady while you're doing yourself, though.
No, I meant, have you ever done one for anybody else?
Oh. No. Nobody else ever mattered enough.
You still haven't told me what I'm getting.
You're getting this. I hope you like it, because it's too late now.
It's nice.
Nice? It's not about nice. On this one bad drop on Palavin, I had to pull Rodriguez out from under a pile of husks. And if I hadn't recognized her ugly fucking boot, I wouldn't have seen her. She'd have died under there. Yeah. Okay, we're done.
Good enough for an ID?
Good enough so that if you're ever hurt, barely breathing, lying under a pile of rubble at the ass end of this war, you're...
Hey. You worry too much.
First time that's ever been a problem for Jack, I'm guessing. Alright. Well, except for finishing up all the challenges at Armac's Arsenal, which, as much fun as that is, I don't feel any deep desire to go do that. Right now, at least. Maybe Monday, after I've finished the game. We are all finished. We will make... finish this episode up with one last... supply run. Here on the Citadel, and then we will, we'll attack the elusive man's base. I shouldn't have anything new to hand in to anybody, so should all just be any last-minute purchases.
Welcome to Casa Fabrication Weaponry.
Thank you for shopping at Casa Fabrication Weaponry.
Welcome to Nos Astra Sporting Goods. Shoot
good
smart.
Hunting.
Shoot, Nos Astra. Welcome to Agor Munitions.
Remember, all purchases made welcome to Super
Team
Agor Munitions will show in your credit report. AM Trading Limited.
Hello, Shepard.
Destination. Okay, we can go see if there's anything new at
arriving at Huerta Memorial Hospital.
Another medical upgrade, perhaps.
Welcome to Serta.
Nope. I guess 8 is the maximum for this game.
Spectre status recognized.
I think I'm purgatory. Okay, embassies. I don't probably can't afford anything out of the Spectre acquisitions, but
now arriving at Presidium Embassy. I have excellent news. Your daughter's paperwork has been processed.
All right. And check out Batarian State Arms, and then back to the Normandy.
Now arriving at Docking Bay E-24, Emergency Civilian Housing.
All right, we have bought everything on the Citadel.
Spectre status recognized.
All right, back onto the Normandy.
Discovered a way to run FTL spaceships without an ESO core private to lobby?
No, ma'am. Then consider this a serious
down to the shuttle bay to upgrade the weapons. So the rate of 5. No. And no 5. Eagle. Oh, okay. I didn't really realize I had fully upgraded that. All right then. So the headquarters of Cerberus is at Anadias in the Horsehead Nebula cluster, Kronos Station. The M1A Red Supergiant Anadias is a minor footnote in the star maps of the Horsehead Nebula, a cold, dying star of about 20 solar masses and 1,500 times Sol's radius. Not listed on any charts, an unobtrusive space station is nearly imperceptible in the star's periodic bursts of solar output. Heedee's advisory. Size and shape of the station suggest many ships could dock in it. Precise measurements would require active scans which could reveal the Normandy's presence. Given the stakes, this level of accuracy is not recommended.
Shepard, the intel you sent looks good. The fleets are ready to go.
But?
Once we're committed against Cerberus, it won't be long before the Reapers take notice.
And the Crucible?
Ready, except for the catalyst. But there's no way to hide the ships we'll be sending at Cerberus. Once we attack, the Crucible won't stay safe for long. For all intents and purposes, an assault on Cerberus will be the first stage of our attack on Earth.
What happens if Cerberus doesn't have the intel we need? Or they stop us from getting it?
Then we lead the fleets to Earth and we take our chances. But your intel points to Cerberus and the elusive man holding the information we're looking for. And we have the element of surprise. Cerberus won't know what hit him.
The Reapers and Cerberus started this. Now we're gonna end it.
I'll get the fleets mobilized.
Yay, another nightmare dream. I said, this nightmare can be like, if you've let a lot of people die, you hear all of their whispers here.
Thank you.
Shepard, we've arrived. The crew is waiting.
The strike team is in. We've got our foothold. Fifth Fleet, all forward. I don't want a single Cerberus ship in my sky when we're through.
Shepard, I should accompany you on this mission.
Why?
This is the central point of operations for Cerberus. They will have enhanced security measures. With my knowledge of Cerberus algorithms and this body's updated protocols, I offer the best chance to help you succeed.
Grab your gear.
So Edie is coming. Godless. Who else? James. Fair enough. Works for me. Can I? Happens if I take ultralight materials off. Okay, that should be fun. A little bit more damage with my guns will probably be helpful.
Joker, what's our status?
We've got a foothold, but it's not much, Commander. A lot of fighters guarding the launch base.
Can you get us in?
Hey, I got us to Ilos. I can do this. It might be a bumpy ride, though.
Do what you can.
Shepard, I am ready.
Wait, what? Are you crazy? You can't go to Cerberus headquarters. They could have a virus or a kill switch or...
I will be fine, Jeff.
Head to the shuttle, Edie.
Fifth Fleet's cut through their line. They're regrouping. Now's as good a time as any.
I know it hurts. Not being able to go with her.
Yeah, it sucks. Thanks for bringing that up. Hey, Shepard. Keep her safe.
Same to you.
Alright, everybody, as always seems to happen, the just hit the end of our episode just at the start of the mission. So, make sure that you check out Dick Dank Full Frontal Attack on all social media platforms, and of course check out the store over on eBay. Stay tuned.